Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be watching some music videos from the princess of R&B herself, Aaliyah. And I'm very much excited for this. I haven't seen any Aaliyah music videos before in my entire life. And recently I listened to all her albums for the first time. Age Ain't Nothing But a Number, One in a Million, and her self-titled from 2001. I also just uploaded a video where I listened to songs from her two compilation albums that were released after her death. Her two posthumous compilation albums released in 2002, 2005 called I Care For You and Ultimate Aaliyah. So now that I've listened to all her music, it's now time to delve into her visuals, her music videos. Now I will be randomizing her music videos, which means I won't know which music videos I'll be watching in today's video, which is always exciting. So I'll be randomizing her music videos between 1 and 20. So without further ado, the first music video I'll be watching in today's video is number 4. This is always so exciting for me. I don't know about you guys, but I just always get so giddy. So number 4 is, oh my god, where am I? 1, 2, 3, 4. If Your Girl Only Knew. Awesome, let's get into it. God, it's already badass. What a room. I like that she's the only one in color there. That's interesting. I love that chair. I love the spikes on the wall. That, ooh, hi. That was hot. See, this is why I love watching music videos, because the music video enhances the song. And now, after watching this music video, I love the song even more, and I'm kind of crazy about it now. Now, this music video did come out in 1996, 25 years ago, from her One in a Million era. I do think this was the lead single from the album, and it was, and it's a great song. It's sexy, I don't need to tell you that. And the visual was hot. I really liked that room she was in with some sort of harness or that white chair and the spikes on the walls, and it was red, and her outfit was interesting too. And the elevator, there was a green light, she was at a party, sexy guys, sexy girls. And the motorcycles in the beginning and the end. The video features cameos from celebrities such as Missy Elliott. Yeah, I noticed Missy Elliott in the video. Timbaland, 702, Lil' Kim, and even Aaliyah's brother. The video begins with Aaliyah, her brother, and their clique arriving to a party on motorcycles. She wears a dark leather outfit with her trademark sunglasses and bandana. Scenes including Aaliyah sitting in a futuristic chair at a party. The party scene is shot in black and white, but Aaliyah remains in color. Aaliyah and various others in an elevator, and also a close-up of Aaliyah's face, Color editing is used on her eyes here, and they change color towards the end of the video. Yeah, her eyes turned green. That was a little creepy. Was there a sling in the video? For some reason, I remember there being a sling, or was it just the white chair? Or do I just have a dirty mind? Okay, so inside the red room with the spikes on the walls, there's this tall frame, and it looks like this looks like some sort of kinky room. I won't lie, with the spikes, and it looks like some sort of sling is supposed to go in the frame, but instead they took it out and put a white chair in there. I don't know, I was definitely getting BDSM vibes from some of the style choices in this video. I think it also had to do with the black leather as well. Just a very sexy video. Definitely a fun music video, and this is getting me pumped up for the other three music videos I'll be watching. So the second video I will be watching is number... oh, five. Going right from 4 to 5, that was easy. One in a million. Hi, Timbaland. Nice eye patch. There's something very alien and futuristic about that room. She sure loves those sunglasses. Wow, she looks gorgeous. She's so seductive. The way she looks into the lens. She's literally making love to the camera. Who's that stud muffin? God, imagine going shopping in that. The return of the motorcycle. I've always wanted to ride a motorcycle. It's so romantic. Well, if I thought the prior music video was sexy, this one's even sexier, and she brought the sex appeal. Like I said already, the way she looks into the lens is very sensual, and she makes love to the camera. And her outfits were quite intriguing. The overall aesthetic of the video I wasn't expecting. It looked quite alien at times. And the eye patch, too. She was wearing leather, just like the prior video, and the motorcycle. Very edgy and badass, but also soft and seductive with the white room and the white outfit. So it's like a mix of hard and soft, the leather and the motorcycle, but also the white tank top she was wearing, and the white pants, and the white room. A sense of purity juxtapositioned against the hardness of the leather and the sunglasses and the motorcycles. Now, the guy in the video was genuine. The scene where Aaliyah was in the dark room strikes a resemblance to the set of 12 Monkeys. Okay, I'm looking at the movie poster. It looks very sci-fi, and it's a 1995 movie, which I've never seen before. It stars Brad Pitt. I've heard of it, and Bruce Willis. I've heard of it, but I've never actually seen it. Not only is she wearing the white tank top and white pants in the white room, but she's also wearing a white bodysuit, which was so sexy on her. The video ends with Aaliyah riding in a motorcycle with 18-year-old Deals, son of Jackie Jackson. Another great music video from Aaliyah, sexy and edgy at the same time, and very memorable. So now let's move on to music video number 3, and it will be... What's happening? Number 2! Okay, we're just going back in time here. Yes! At Your Best, You Are Love. This random number generator... I'm on to you. Okay, I'm ready. She always opens her music videos with a vehicle. Yeah, and the sunglasses. I was gonna say, who's that sexy guy, but I realized it's R. Kelly. So first and foremost, I want to say that I was a little confused because as I started listening to the song, it didn't sound familiar to me. I was like, this isn't the same song I remember. This doesn't sound like At Your Best, You Are Love. It's not how I remember it when I listened to AJ Nothing But a Number. And I'm reading here that it's actually not the original version, it's a remix. The video is for the remix of the song, not the original, and R. Kelly, who produced the song, is in the video. I was a little disappointed because I do prefer the album version. I'm not the biggest fan of this remix. I definitely prefer the slower, sultry version of this song. So I was disappointed. I was also disappointed in the music video. It was nice for what it was, but I thought it was a little boring and nothing was really happening. It was essentially just a group of people hanging out and vibing to the song, dancing to the song, and that's about it. I really do think this was a missed opportunity. But anyway, we've made it to the 4th music video of my video, and it will be number 7. So number 7 is One in a Million, the remix, which... I don't know, I already watched a music video for the original One in a Million, so I feel like it's a little unfair for me to watch 2 One in a Million music videos. So I am going to do something I don't usually do in these videos. I'm gonna skip over this one because I want to watch a music video for another song that I haven't listened to yet in this video. So moving right along, officially, the 4th music video I'll be watching is number 13. So I'll be watching Try Again from the Romeo Must Die soundtrack. Oh my. This is so Y2K. Try again, touch yourself up and try again, try again. Her body is smoking. Her makeup is very sexy and intense. Get a girl. Oh yeah, the cane. Look at that ass. Look at that ass, indeed. Not just her ass though, her abs and her arms and just overall her stomach and everything. Her face, she looks gorgeous. Her makeup was quite intense, I won't lie. And her hair was great, and just a very sultry, sexy human being. She's like a siren from mythology. She lures sailors and pirates to their deaths with her beautiful voice. And the ship comes along because the sailors are like, "What's that beautiful voice?" And then the siren just drowns the ship, shipwrecks everyone, kills all the men. The choreography in this video was on point. And the visuals, the sets, and the overall design was very much Y2K. And when did this video come out? 2000. Literally Y2K, the year 2000. So it has that aesthetic, 100%. Now the video also features Jet Li entering a Hall of Mirrors. I like that part. And Aaliyah stepping in wearing a revealing low-cut bra and tight low-rise leather pants. I'm pretty sure she's worn leather in all the music videos I've watched today. The song is also fire. It's great, it's catchy, it's addicting, and I quite enjoyed myself. God, I almost forgot to mention her bedazzled bra. And that neck piece. Wow. So what did you guys think of the music videos I watched, and what are your impressions of them? And I am a little disappointed that I didn't watch any of the music videos from her 2001 Aaliyah era, but there's always going to be a part two to this series, part two, a part three, so I will be doing more Aaliyah music video medley videos in the future. So thanks for watching, guys. You can find me on Twitter, you can find me on Instagram, you can say, "Hey, how are you?" And I will see you next time. Take care.